So we are doing Dadi Shabda, and so the last time we did Dadi Shabda, so from the beginning we can discuss again. Dadi Yuktasu, so Brahmata Swamur Mahaharaha, by that sutra, because Dadi is in Brahmalinga, neuter gender, so we deleted the Su by the sutra Brahmata Swamur Mahaharaha. Then Dadhi Yukta Au, 1-2. So there Radha Brahma Bhyam Au E. Au is replaced by Trivikrama E. And then Brahma Shanta Nuk Sarveshvare Natvami. By that sutra, we inserted Nuk. And ultimately we get Dadhi Neen. Right? Then Shas, Jas, sorry. Here, we had Brahmato Jas Shasoh Shi. So Jas is replaced by Shi. And then Brahmeshanta Nuk Sarveshwari Natvami. And then Nant Dhatu Vajita Santa Satsanga Mahadapam Uddhavasya Trivikramaha Krishna Sthane Buddham Vina. That sutra. So what is Krishna Sthana? Abrahma Pandava Shishta Krishna Sthana Sangya. We read it last time. She is also Krishna Sthana. And Pandavas, except in Brahmalinga, they are also Krishna Sthana. So, yeah. So there is, and this is Na Anta. This word has Na Rama at its end. So thus we made the Uddhava of this word Trivikrama. So we got the Dhini. I hope this is clear. Then moving ahead. Two, one, two, two, and 2-3, they are same like 1-1, 1-2, and 1-3. So we move to 3-1. Dadhi Yukta Ta. Okay. Now here comes another sutra. Dadhi Asthi Sakthi Akshi Shabdanam E Ramasya Antadi Sarveshwari. The E Rama of the words Dadhi Asthi Sakthi and Akshi is replaced by An. Yeah, please, again. So, E Rama of the words Dadhi, Asthi, Sakthi and Akshi is replaced by An when any Vishnu Bhakti beginning with Sarveshwara follows from Ta onwards. So, from Ta onwards, 3.1 onwards, when any Vishnu Bhakti follows which begin with the Sarveshwara, then E Rama of these words is changed by An. So by this sutra, this is Ta and we have the word Dadhi. So the E Rama is changed by An and then we have Ta, Arimani. Sutra number 168. Okay. Then we have a sutra again. This is Sangha Sutra, a definition. A Krishna Sthana Sarveshwaro Bhagavat Sangha Tadhite Yascha. Now this is Bhagavat Sangha. What is Bhagavat? Any Swadhi that is not a Krishna Sthana and that begins with a Sarveshwara is called a Bhagavat. So any Vishnu Bhakti, any Pratyaya out of the Swadhi, Suaujas, Amoshas, Ityadi, which is not a Krishna Sthana, which is not Krishna Sthana, and which begins with Sarveshwara, is Bhagavat Sangha. Okay? And any Tadhita Pratyaya that begins with Sarveshwara or Yarama is also called Bhagavat. So this is also there. So Ta is Bhagavat Sangha. because ta is not Krishna sthana first of all, and it begins with the Sarveshwara, so ta is Bhagavat Sangya. Then this sutra is there. Va ma satsanga hinasyanu rama haro bhagavati na tu ye inyastu va. So this sutra says, so this sutra says, sutra number 170, that if the a of an portion of a word ending in an is related when a bhagavat follows, provided the an portion is not preceded by a satsanga containing va or ma. So the an, when we have any shabda which has an and which is not preceded by any satsanga which contains va rama or ma rama. Satsanga is conjunct consonant. So then, and if Bhagavat follows after this an, then the a rama of an is deleted. So here a is Bhagavat and we have dadhan which ends with an, so the a of dadhan is deleted, so we get dadhna. And of course there is no satsanga before dadhan, what to speak of satsanga having va or ma, so we get dadhna. Clear? And this sutra also says that if it is ni, ni is also Bhagavat, then the a of an is optionally deleted. That will stay. See. Okay. Does it make sense, this sutra? So first of all, we read what is Bhagavat Sangya. Again, Bhagavat Sangya means any Vishnu Bhakti beginning with Sarve Krishna, Sarveshwara, that is not Krishna sthana. I hope you know what is Krishna sthana. Is Bhagavat. Is Bhagavat. Clear? And also before that we studied in 168 sutra that dadhi asti sakti akshi shabdanam iramasya antadi sarveshwari, that of the word dadhi asti sakti akshi, so the e rama of these words, e rama of these words becomes what? An. From ta onwards. So these are the three sutras which we studied. 168, 169, 170. Is it clear? The final form we made, dadhana?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Then 3-2, dadhi. Simple, dadhi bhyam, nothing new. Similarly, 3-3, dadhi bhi. Then 4-1, dadhi yukta ne. So again, we do it like 3-1. So first of all, Sutra 168, Dadhi Asti Sakti Shakshi Shabdanam Iramasya Antadi Sarveshwari Dadhan Yuktange Ehri means, and then Vama Satsanga Hinasya Anu Ramaharu Bhagavati Natu Yengastuva. By that sutra, A of Dadhan is deleted and we get Dadhane. So then the Dadibhyam, Dadibhyah, 5-1 will be Dadhanaha. Dadhanaha. Yeah, please try doing this. Dadhi Yuktangasi. Yeah, please do this. Dadhi Yuktangasi. Apply these three sutras, 168, 169, and 170.
Can you repeat the question? I just joined. Sorry.
Yeah, I'm saying please do this, decline this, Dadhi Yuktangasi. Okay. Using these three sutras, 168, 169, 170.
Okay.
Please send me on Telegram when you're done. Yeah, so that was it. I hope you got it. So Dadhi Yuktangasi, and first of all, we apply Dadhi Asti Sakti Akshi Shabdanam E Ramasya Antadi Sarveshwari, by which the E Rama of Dadhi changes to An. And we have Aso Fungasi. Then Vama Satsanga Himasyanu Ramaharo Bhagavati Natu Yangastuva. By that sutra, we delete the A of Dadhan and we get this and we combine it. Then Sara Ramyur Vishnu Sarva Vishnu Padanti Dadhanaha. Okay, Dadhanaha. Then Dadhibhyam. Dadhipyaha 6-1 will be same like 5-1. Dadhanaha, Dadhno, Dadhnam, and Dadh. Okay, 7-1. Dadhi Yukni. So, first of all, E is replaced by An. by Dadi Asti Sakti Akshi Shabda Nami Rama Santa Adi Sarveshwari. And then that Vama Satsanga Hinasyano Rama Haro Bhagavati Natu Yanyo Suva. So that sutra says that when Ni follows, then the A of that An is optionally deleted. So when it is deleted, so we get this Dadhani, and when it is not deleted, then we get Dadhani, both the forms. Then Dadhano, Dadhishu, He Dadhi, He Dadhini, He Dadhini, like that. Oh, okay. In 8.1, there is some change, new rule. Dadhi, Yukta Su. So, we have a sutra here which says, Brahmano Govindo Va Buddhe. A Brahma optionally takes Govinda when Buddha follows. Okay, so in Dadhi we have E Rama, so Govinda for E Rama is A. So optionally we do Govinda when Buddha follows. So when we do Govinda, it becomes A, Dadhe Yukta Su, Dadhe, and when Govinda is not done, then Dadhi. And in both, at both the places, to delete Su, we apply that sutra, 110. A.O. Vamanebhyo Buddhasya Darshanam. So we get He Dadhe, He Dadhi. And He Dadhi, He Dadhini, He Dadhini. So this is the table.
One question here. Yes. In 168, it mentions from Ta onwards. So does Sambodhana also come in Ta onwards or no?
Dadi Asti Sakti. He Ramasya Antadi Sarveshwari. Antadi Sarveshwari. No, it doesn't. No.
So whenever it says onwards, Sambodhana should not be considered, is it?
No, no. There should be like a special mention for Sambodhana.
Okay.
The words Asthi, Sakthi and Akshi are declined in the same way. So, Asthi, Sakti and Akshi, they are declined in the same way. Please decline Akshi. Yeah. Please decline Akshi. Same way. The word Akshi. Same like Dadhi, same sutras like Dadhi. Text 26. No, actually we did this, 26, I remember. 27. ऋषयो मनवो देवा मनुपुत्रा महौजसः कलाः सर्वे हरेरेव स प्रजापतयः स्मृताः स प्रजापतयः प्रजापतिभिः सहिताः ऋषयः मुनिवृन्दाः मनवः देवाः महौजसः अतिपराक्रान्ताः मनुपुत्राः मानवाश्च सर्वे एव हरेः कलाः स्मृताः अंशस्वरूपाः प्रकीर्तिताः देन आफ्टर टेलिंग नरेटिंग अबाउट ऑल द इनकार्नेशंस लाइक द प्राइमरी वंस देन सूत गोस्वामी सेइंग दैट अलोंग विद ऑल द प्रजापतिस स प्रजापतयः All the Rishi Munis, all the Manus, all the demigods who are Ati Maha Ojasa, who possesses great strength, valor, and all the Manuputra, the sons of Manu, basically the Manava, the humans, all of them, Sarve Eva, they are the Ansha Swarupa, they are part and parcel of Lord Hari. So it is Prakirtita, it is understood, it is said like that. It is well known that all the rishis, prajapatis, manus, demigods, manushyas, humans, they are all ansha, part and parcel of Lord Hari. Because if Suta Goswami goes on taking the name of each and every individual, then the whole Bhagavatam will just be about that. So he's just summing up his the topic like this. Then he says this, Ete Changsh Kalah Pungsah Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam Indrari Vyakulam Lokam Mridayanti Yuge Yuge. After narrating about all the primary incarnations and yeah. Now Suta Goswami is saying that एते पूर्व उक्ताः ब्रह्मादयः पुंसः परमेश्वरस्य अंश कलाः केचित् अंशाः केचित् कलाः विभूतयः यथा उपयोगं ज्ञानक्रिया शक्त्या वेशात् अवतेणाः संतः इंद्रारि व्याकुलं सुर दुषे दैत्यैः उपद्रुतम् लोकम भुवनम युगे युगे प्रतियुगम मृडयन्ति सुखिनम कुर्वन्ति तु किंतु कृष्णः स्वयं भगवान् न तु कृष्णः अपि भगवतः अंशावतारः आविष्कृत सर्वशक्तित्वात् सो हियर सुत गोस्वामी इज सेइंग दैट ऑल द इनकार्नेशंस एंड ऑल द अदर Ansha Swarupa, part and parcels of Lord Hari, they are basically Ansh and Kala of the Supreme Lord. Ansh and Kala. Some they are Ansha, some they are Kala. So basically part and parcels of the Lord. So then in the Anvaya it is said, यथा उपयोगम ज्ञान क्रिया शक्त्या वेशात अवतीर्णा संत दे आर इन्वेस्टेड विद द एनर्जीज ऑफ द लॉर्ड एज मच एज इट इज रिक्वायर्ड ऑल दीज डिफरेंट इंकार्नेशंस ऑल ओवर दीज डिफरेंट अंशस ऑफ द लॉर्ड दे या इट इज मेनली अबाउट द इंकार्नेशंस Rishi Munis, demigods, mainly like that. So they are all invested with the Shakti, the energy of the Lord, the Jnana energy, the Kriya Shakti. Yatha Upayogam, as much as it is required for, yeah, Yatha Upayogam. And thus they incarnate with that. I will not say limited energy, but it says yatha upayogam as required. So such incarnations, Ansh, Kala, they, what do? Yuge Yuge, Prati Yugam, in every Yuga, every millennium, they make this Bhuvanam, this world, happy, Sukhinam, which is disturbed, harmed by the demons again and again. And the demons are Suradvisha, Daityai. They are Daityas, they are demons who are averse, who envy demigods. So such incarnations, they come again and again, they incarnate themselves and they make this world happy, which is terrorized by the demons, by the Daityas, who are the enemy of the demigods. But Krishna, Lord Krishna, is Swayam Bhagwan. He is the Swayam Bhagwan, which means he is the Moola Bhagwan, we can say, Adi Bhagwan. And then Sridhar Swami says, Natu Krishna api Bhagavata ansh avatarah. It means that Krishna is also not considered like one of the incarnation of the Lord. By saying Krishna Swayam Bhagwan, it is to be understood that Krishna is also not like, Krishna is also not like one of the incarnations of the Lord. No. He is not just one simple incarnation, a normal incarnation of the Lord. Rather, he is Swayam Bhagwan because Avishkrita Sarva Shaktitvat. Because in him rests the Sarva Shakti Manatva. He is the Sarva Shakti Man. He is the abode of all the energies. From him springs all energies in different ways, in various ways. Iti Artha, this is the meaning. This verse is very deep, and even in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami talks at great length about this shloka. Iti Artha. Okay, any question in this shloka 28? Okay, next. Janma Guhyam Bhagavato Ya etat prayato naraha sayam pratar grinan bhaktya dukha grama advimuchyate. Yaha naraha lokaha prayataha shuchihisan bhagavataha etat kuhyam atirahasyam janma vrittantam sayam pratah grinan uchcharayan tishthati iti sheshaha saha dukha gramat. दुःखाकरात् संसारात् विमुच्यते विमुक्तः भवति यः नरः वन हु अ मैन हु बीइंग प्यूरिफाइड शुचिः सन् ही रिसाइट्स उच्चारयन् इन द मॉर्निंग प्रातः एंड इन द इवनिंग सायं द नरेशन of the pastimes, of the confidential pastimes, the confidential birth of the Lord. So one who basically narrates the pastimes of the Lord who advents in different incarnations and like that, which are all confidential topics, Ati Rahasyam. So such a person, Saha, he is freed, Vimuktaha, from this samsara, from this material world, which is basically nothing but abode of all miseries. Dukhakara. Akara means abode, akara. Dukhakarat samsarat vimuchyate. Okay, clear? So one who narrates the pastimes every morning, evening of the Lord, he becomes freed from the effects of this material world.
Prabhu, what's the word for secrets? Secret?
Ati Rahasyam. गुह्यम
अतिदस्ति यस ओके
राजविद्या राजगुह्यम सो गुह्यम ओके देन एतद् रूपं भगवतो यरूपस्य चिदात्मनः माया गुणैर विरचितं महदादिभिरात्मनि अरूपस्य चिदात्मनः रूप गुण विवर्जितस्य चित एकरसस्य हरेः जीवस्य वा एतत् स्थूलं विराट रूपं शरीरं भगवतः महदादिभिः माया गुणैः भगवतः माया तस्याः गुणैः महत्तत्वादिभिः आदि पञ्चविंशति तत्त्वैः आत्मनि जीवे विरचितं आत्मस्थाने कृतम् इति अर्थः विल डू दिस श्लोक टुमारो फ्रॉम हियर सो दिस इज लिटिल टेक्निकल सो विल स्टडी दिस टुमारो ओके सो विल स्टॉप हियर